अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन लाइट इंडिपेंडेंट और डार्क रिएक्शन ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस। इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज केल्विन साइकिल आर C3 पाथवे। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, हाउ कैन वी डिफाइन इट? द साइक्लिक सीरीज ऑफ रिएक्शंस व्हिच आर कैटलाइज्ड बाय एंजाइम्स बाय व्हिच द कार्बन इज फिक्स्ड एंड रिड्यूस्ड, resulting in the synthesis of sugar during the dark reaction of photosynthesis is called as Kelvin cycle. Dark reactions are light independent reactions, means they do not need light directly. These reactions take place in the stroma of chloroplast. While you know light reactions, they occur on the membranes of thylakoids, which are part of chloroplast. These reactions, I told you, do not need light directly and can occur in the presence or absence of light if ATP and NADPH produced during light reactions are available. Students, energy of these compound ATP and NADPH2 is actually used to form carbohydrates from carbon dioxide. The path of carbon in these reactions was discovered by Melvin Kelvin and his colleagues at the University of California. Kelvin was awarded Nobel Prize in 1961. That's why it is called as Kelvin cycle. Now I will explain phases of Kelvin cycle. Kelvin cycle, it is completed in three phases. First phase is called as carbon fixation. Second phase is called as reduction. And third phase is called as regeneration of RUBP. First of all, what is carbon fixation? I will explain that. Students, in this cycle we are following with three molecules of carbon dioxide. The Kelvin cycle begins when a molecule of carbon dioxide reacts with ribulose bisphosphate, RUBP. Actually, three molecules of carbon dioxide, they react with three molecules of RUBP during the cycle to produce one molecule of carbohydrate or a triose, which is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. RUBP is highly reactive phosphorylated 5-carbon sugar. Ribulose bisphosphate that reacts with carbon dioxide in the presence of an enzyme called as Rubisco. This is called as Rubisco because it functions both as carboxylase as well as oxygenase. Means it can combine oxygen with RUBP as well as carbon dioxide with RUBP. Over here it is working or functioning as carboxylase. It is the most abundant protein in chloroplast and probably the most abundant protein on earth, because you know enzymes, they are protein in nature. So this enzyme that is considered as most abundant protein in the nature as well as in the chloroplast. So students, what I told you, when three carbon dioxide molecules, they combine with three RUBP molecules in the presence of Rubisco, they form 6 molecules of 3-phosphoglycerate. This is a 3-carbon acid, And how many molecules they are produced? 6 molecules of this acid they are produced. As this acid is a 3-carbon sugar, that's why Calvin cycle, and it is the first product of Calvin cycle, that's why Calvin cycle is also called as C3 pathway. Now it is clear to you why do we call it light independent reactions, because light that doesn't require directly during the process, it is called as Calvin cycle after the name of its discoverer, and it is called as C3 pathway because the first compound which is formed during the cycle, that is a 3-carbon compound. Now the carbon that was originally part of carbon dioxide is now a part of an organic molecule, because you know carbon dioxide is an inorganic molecule, but now it has become a part of what? An organic molecule. So we say that carbon that has been fixed, hence this whole process is called as carbon fixation, or the first phase is called as carbon fixation. Second phase is called as reduction. But students, it is completed in 2 steps. First of all, from 3-phosphoglycerate, a molecule or an intermediate that is formed, which is called as 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. As we are proceeding now with 6 molecules of organic molecule or organic compound which is phosphoglycerate, that's why 6 ATPs they are required to convert this 3-phosphoglycerate into another 3-carbon compound, which is what? 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Means before, with only 3rd carbon of phosphate group that was attached, but after ATPs they provide phosphate group to this 3-phosphoglycerate molecule, it gets changed into what? Into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate with carbon number 1 a phosphate group that will get attached. Secondly, this 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate that will reduce to glyceraldehyde. So it will require hydrogen, and this hydrogen that will be provided through NADPH, which is formed during light reaction. Both ATP and NADPH, which are used during Calvin cycle, they are produced during light reaction. In this way, fixed carbon is reduced to energy-rich glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, or it is also called as 3-PGAL, 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. Means after the use of ATP and NADPH, phosphoglycerate that gets changed into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. During this reduction process, a phosphate group from each 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate that is given off or that gets removed. Next, students, from the Calvin cycle, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate that is produced directly, and this is not glucose, it requires another glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate molecule to get changed into what? Into glucose, which is what? Which is a 6-carbon compound, because glyceraldehyde that is a 3-carbon compound, so it will get changed into a 6-carbon compound when another glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate group that will react with this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So total 6 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, they are produced and they contain 6 threes are 18, 18 carbon in all. However, only one molecule of glyceraldehyde that leaves the cycle, and remaining 5 glyceraldehyde they move or proceed to regenerate RUBP. This glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate that is used by the plant for making not only glucose, but it can also produce sucrose, which is sugar, starch or other carbohydrates, and rest of the organic compounds. Now, third step is regeneration of RUBP, which is a carbon dioxide acceptor. Now, through a complex series of reaction, glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate that gets changed into RUP, ribulose phosphate. It gets changed into what? Into RUP, which is a 5 carbon sugar, or 5 carbon, sorry, molecule. Over here, 3 ATP, they are used and they convert RUP, ribulose phosphate molecule, into RUBP, ribulose bisphosphate. And then this RUBP will be ready to regenerate again 3-phosphoglycerate. The whole process of Calvin cycle indicates that there are 3 molecules of carbon dioxide, 6 molecules of NADPH, and 6 plus 3, 9 molecules of ATP are used to release just 1 molecule of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. However, in order to produce 1 glucose molecule, 2 molecules of G3P or PGAL are required. That's all for today.